I'm now back and I've done something between episodes. First of all, I've put all of the things in our storage system. You can see here. And I've used this wall to make what is it called? To write down what we've planned in the future. So we have to get ender pearls, which is should be easy with looting free. Get blaze rods, where we have to find a fortress. I want to get an infinity bow so that I don't need to farm arrows for the dragon fight. I need a slow falling potion so that the ender dragon doesn't kill me when he pushes me into the air, and then I finally have to kill the ender dragon. So I think we can get started with the first two things, which are getting ender pearls and getting blaze rods. I will do what's easier first. Let's look into the nether. So I'm now here by the fortress. No, please stop it. And there's a spawner and a wither skeleton, and I think I will just go and trade with some piglins with the gold I farmed, and maybe some more gold I will farm, so that I can get ender pearls first, but also that I can get some fire protection potions so that the blazes don't set me on fire. So I'm now back from getting ender pearls and blaze rods. Ender pearls I got from the piglins, and I decided a few things. First, we don't need an infinity bow because of the spectral arrows we got. All of the arrows that should be way more than we need for the end crystals. Then I don't need the slow falling potion. I will just gonna go take a bit more gold and try to get a few more ender pearls so that we can just pearl down if the dragon shoots us up. And I of course remove the blaze rod shield because we have enough blaze rods already. So I think I'm now gonna go into the nether and get a few ender pearls. So I've now got the ender pearls here and also a bit more arrows. And I think that's actually everything I need for the wither fight. The dragon fight. And I'm a bit scared of going there, but don't think it will be a huge problem. And yeah, I know about the pumpkin, but I do not use it normally. And I'm not planning on using it here. I need a water bucket, that's really important. And I've already looked, I'm so sorry, but I can enchant my bow. That's something I will do so that I am faster and I shoot with power 3, which is not too bad. And I'm also looking for something else, and it is to get maybe blast protection can be helpful. Protection 4. Oh, I can get protection 4. So I could disenchant, for example, my leggings would be the most efficient thing. So I can just go here and disenchant it and make protection 4. And I've also got unbreaking now, which is helpful too. I can now just go and look for the stronghold. Believe it or not, but that's the best thing that has ever happened to me. I'm nearly here. I'm already on coordinates nearly 1000. So the stronghold should be somewhere in this direction and not so far away. And I had already planned to go back once because I forgot to take my whole food. And now I just found a village where I can make bread. That's really the best thing that happened to me. Little update again. I found a jungle temple and there were really much bones, a bit of gunpowder and spider eyes and strings. Spider eyes will be useful for my villagers, for the potions. A bit of iron and another looting free book, which is also really helpful. So I found the right location of the stronghold now. It should be here somewhere. It's not, can't see it from here. But my enderpearl got straight into here, so I think I can dig down. Think I should be there soon. Yeah, I'm here. I finally found the portal after more than half an hour of looking for it, I think. And two eyes, that's not too bad. Just to be sure. I'm a bit scared. I'm really scared. And let's go in. Okay, spawn here. First spawn. Oh, I have to be careful about the things. He spits at me about the bad effect. But I've got good aim at this point, I think. At least for me. Oh yeah, really good aim. Oh, go away. First heart. Yeah, I've got it. Yeah, he has no more crystals. Can just shoot at him. Oh, I have to be careful. He's coming. Okay, it's working. Didn't shoot me actually far, but I now at least know that my pearls are working. Didn't notice that the glowing effect is not working at the dragon. I didn't know that. Good. Not anymore. Yeah. And I just noticed that I forgot something. And something is a torch for the dragon egg. Oh, all the levers. I'm not sure, but is this possible too? Yeah, so intelligent. I would actually like to get an elytra. So I'm now here in the end, and I went through the portal, and I spawned, literally. I spawned so, like this. Luckily I was sneaking, and I have tons of blocks in my inventory, and I think we'll be really careful, but obviously it's possible that we can TP there. Oh, I found my portal, that's nice. We'll just write the coordinates in the chat. No. Don't attack me, don't attack me. Stop it. One Enderman isn't actually too bad. And I found my first ship. Yes, ship. But my first NCD was what I would like to say. Oh, the double Sharker Shells mod. It's nice. Oh, and I also have something to say. Maybe you noticed the creeper not exploding anything thing is off again, and I noticed that I also do not get damage. I didn't know that, and maybe you know say that's completely fake, you didn't survive hardcore, and I would agree with you. You can't compare me now anymore with someone who survived who also survived hardcore for the same period or even longer. But I also have to say, I do not really care so much, because, wait, oh god, I was really shocked, because like, I don't plan on being famous for surviving hardcore for so long, or things like this. It's more like a personal challenge for me, and I want to make videos, but in my videos there's it's mostly about things I enjoy in Minecraft, like building farms and having materials, but also and mostly building structures, building nice spaces and other things. And that's good to speak about. Oh, mending. It's good to speak about the next thing I wanted to mention, and that is my plan for the series. I actually have some sort of plan, I would say. Are you angry at me? And the plan is to just make survival and build the structures around it. That it works like I need a farmer villager to get apples and make more villagers. I build a farm and there he can live. And or now I need a librarian for enchantments, so I build some kind of house some kind of bookstore maybe, and then I build a church to get the villager with the name I forgot now, the one who obviously lives in a church, and things like that. That's my plan for it. And my style is that I will try to make you, Elytra, to make like things that are detailed as good as possible. That's the most important thing for me. Just detail as much as I can so that I think it looks good, and also try new things out, make like get a better horizon and go out of my comfort zone. Oh, the loot is nice. With the diamonds, mostly. Also some good other things. Diamond gear, for example. But mostly I got a good amount of diamonds. About 11 or 12 ender chests, maybe. For the time. Because for me, it would just be completely embarrassing to not die with the elytra already. Because I want more, like, shulker chests. I think I said ender chests, I mean shulker chests. Okay. Nine shulker chests. I'm fine. And I found the portal. Oh, this enderman. And I'm so happy to go out of the end. So I'm now here and I've got a new helmet with protection 4, which I've not on this, is only 3, and aqua affinity will be really helpful at some point, hopefully. And I've now cut the video that the things of the video I've already made, and it's a bit too short and I didn't take really long to do it this time. Not even half as long as last time. And maybe you can remember the geode we cleared out in the first episode. And I decided I want to make like a room so that I can easily mine all of my amethyst shards. And that's what I'm gonna do now. I think I'm gonna build it out of blackstone, just because I can. So I'm now back from building my little farming area here, where I can easily mine all of the things. And I've actually already mined it. Really successful. Went there, mined it. Found out that I could also use my fortune pickaxe. Went back. Mine it with my fortune pickaxe. Perfect day. But I got an unexpected amount of resources. More than 19 stacks. Which means there are nearly 5 stacks of amethyst blocks. So it will be really helpful to mine here in the future. But there's also something else I'm going to do, and that is getting nether wards for making potions. And guess what I did next? Getting nether wards. Falls. I just chilled a bit. Went fishing, then it began to rain, and I went to bed. Slept under my chests. Then I farmed a few crops to not be too hungry. Then I went fishing again on another spot, and then I decided I could go and get nether wards. So I'm now here in the fortress and would first like to look a bit where I could possibly go. But there's literally nothing. So, after a few dangerous situations, I went back home. We actually have a nearly perfect armor now. So here we only need mending. We need only mending on all of them. And I think, what do we need? What else do we need? Death Strider. And Death Strider and Feather Falling on this. So just a mending villager and then Death Strider and Feather Falling. I've now actually got one day of playtime. So I can now write the title. I survived one day in Minecraft and killed the Ender Dragon. Bye bye.